None.
Go to the airport. Gets it.
It's so funny at the airport because they'll, you know, the first time I went there, nobody knew because it was the first series. And I went to the counter and I said, have you got a ticket, please, for Sue Nicholson? She goes, where are you going? I said, I don't know. And she, it was very strange. They looked at me and then the next series, you know, came out and they went, you're that psychic lady. Where are we off to today?
The psychics are given absolutely no information ahead of time. So they don't know, or the only piece of information they're given is to turn up at the airport on a certain day. They're not told what the flight is, where the flight's going. They don't have access to their Airpoints accounts numbers online so they can check the flight. They don't actually have access to the booking. It has to be retrieved through a code so they can't ring the airline to change their booking. It's all done and controlled by the production office.
They ask, what date do you want to, are you available on this date? And you come back and say yes or no. And then they send you a flight. Now, I come from Australia, of course, so my flight's always into New Zealand, so I know I'm coming to New Zealand. And so I'll fly into New Zealand, wouldn't have a clue where I'm going. So one of them, you know, that flew me in, they said, oh, you've got another plane to catch. Oh, okay. Then we've got a 2-hour drive. Oh, okay. So I have no idea where I'm going or what I'm doing.
I don't want to know anything. It makes it really, really tough, but you can either crack it or you can't, you know, and at the end of the day, it's best to know nothing because then there's no preconceived idea of the way things have worked, and you don't buy into the innuendo and the speculation. You're just doing what you do and relying totally on the person that's passed away to be able to shed the information with you.